every Friday and shit. Yeah. And then, after school, we go walk like La Pacific. Back in the day, like they had the radio show on Carnalillo and shit.
Yeah.
So we would go looking for him, like to come on TV. Yeah. To come on TV. And we would be all like all deep, all little paisillas and shit, and to get a shout out, cause they would let you like shout your people out. But it's for performance, you know.
Oh yeah, like so you play music.
Yeah.
Like what's your favorite song to play for? You never get tired of it.
Nah, to be honest, bro, cause like it takes so much attention from you, like it requires so much attention that you kind of forget about everything else. Like you don't have time to think about other things. So it's a great way to kill stress.
What instrument do you play?
The bajo sexto, bajo quinto.
Bajo sexto.
It's like a that's guitar.
It's a gun, fool. A gun. That's a fucking metralleta.
No, it's a guitar, right?
Yeah.
And it has like 17 strings on it.
10 strings.
10 strings. You see? Because traditional guitars have what, six?
Six.
See, I know my music.
Yeah. I don't know shit, bro. I just know bateria. The only way I cargo batería, güey, es marisco. So, welcome back to another episode of the Little Brown Boys Podcast. I'm Frankie, that's Pancho, and today we have a very special guest, Charolitas Playa Larga. Practically, ooh, Charolitas Long Beach,
that's right?
Right.
Yes.
That's right. Oh, we got a good friend, Joel Rosas here, Madeline.
Maryland.
You don't like your name in
Spanish?
Spanish.
No, not in Spanish.
My bad. Marilyn Maldonado. So, bro, welcome to the Little Brown Boys Podcast. How do you like the studio?
It's nice, bro. Thanks for the invite.
Yeah. I know. Sometimes I look at it too.
You got Juan Camané, Turulú right here.
Oh, yeah. You see, you already know.
You got Kobe.
Full of culture.
Yeah. Dog. So it's like, it's Hispanic Heritage Month, and it wouldn't be a better guest than introduce the episode, the podcast with a better guest than you guys. A company who specializes in ceviche, charolitas, mariscos, tacos dorados. Bro, when they hit us up, I was like, yes. Should say no more. Yes. Yeah. So let's talk about the product, bro. Like, how'd you guys come about starting this company?
So it came about, it started in like during the pandemic, bro. Pre-pandemic, we would already eat a lot of mariscos because my dad, he's a shrimp farmer in Mexico.
Orale.
So he goes every year and he does his thing, you know. It's like corn. Like you put the seed and it grows, and then at the end of the year you cultivate what you.
That's fucking dope. That's
but he does crazy. That with shrimp.
What part of Mexico?
In Nayarit. On the coast.
Oh yeah, nice. Yeah, shout out Nayarit, bro. That shit is beautiful. Yeah.
So like just the culture, bro. Like my mom and my parents just always making it, making it, and then just I like it. So pre-pandemic, we were just eating a lot of marisco. We were locked inside, and then one day her mom was like, you guys should sell this.
Yeah. So you were making it for her family, practically.
Yeah, basically, like just for us.
Yeah,
for...
I learned it when we got together. I learned it kind of from his mom. I'm from Jalisco. My parents are from Jalisco.
Yeah.
So marisco is not really a big thing.
Right.
Except for my dad would always make ceviche de pescado. And I know people from Nayarit have their own style. And the only way that I knew it was my dad's style. And to me, you know, I was like, my dad shit is fire. I was like, I know no more than this, you know? And then we got together and, well, his family's from Nayarit. And his mom makes mariscos, like fire. And I was like, well, I'm going to have to pick up some shit from her, you know? So then the pandemic hit and I just started cooking. We didn't have anything else to do besides cook.
Yeah.
He would grill, I would cook inside, and we would just do a bunch of random shit. And like he said, we were like, we should sell food. And we were just waiting for my mom one day to mention it, like, you guys should sell it. And we looked at each other like, let's go.
Green light.
Like,
let's do it. That's dope. That's how you start a business right there. Fool in love and shit. Hell yeah, dog. You just be like, yeah, baby, what's up? Trying to get this money? Trying to get this feria? Yeah, let's roll. Bonnie and Clyde over here with a fucking shrimp farm and shit. Yeah, but that's crazy, bro. Like, that's how we kind of started, like, getting into, like, the podcasting, too. Like, throughout the pandemic, we started, like, hey, let's double down. And then we saw the opportunity of like supporting our own community, where it's the most like your community gives you the most. Like it's where people buy your product, people like follow you, and and if you have something to offer, you know what I mean. But and that's tight, dog. So like, what would be one of your signature plates?
Signature plates? Well, we do trays mainly. We have hot and cold food. We just recently started growing our menu.
Mm-hmm.
Originally, we started with just ceviche with aguachiles. Mm-hmm. Just aguachiles and ceviche de camarón. Those are the only two items. And then people liked it, and I was like, hey, you know what? Like, let's start adding like little things, like, you know. And then with the whole social media, you already know, like, people want the new thing. They want the new thing. Yeah.
They want the new.
So every time we take out a new dish, it would blow up. It would blow up like on our feed and stuff. It would blow up. So we're like, all right, let's use this business model. Let's use new dishes constantly, and then we do like a drop. So like we're gonna say this is gonna drop this day. Put in your orders, right. And so we would like accumulate a good following for one dish, and then boom. So different people know us from different dishes.
Right.
Yeah, okay. But I would say like the main, our specialty would be our aguachiles. Uh-huh. And our ceviche.
So what do you have here? Like, what did you guys bring us here? Like, what would be this be?
So, el blanco is ceviche de pescado.
Uh-huh. I don't even know how to eat way. This.
And then the black side one is our ceviche de camarón negro with camarón cocido. So we have our traditional ceviche de camarón, which is crudo, which is how it's from Nayarit. That's how they serve it. It's traditional. You know, it's your Mexican traditional ceviche de camarón. Uh-huh. But we put a little twist to it just because I feel, especially coming from Long Beach, you know, Long Beach is so diverse. You have all types of culture. And we want to serve to everybody. Right. So this one specifically is for somebody who likes it a little bit more cooked. Who doesn't like it raw, but with our signature salsa negra that we make from scratch.
You want some food?
Yeah.
You want some dog? I'm here for you, dog. You know what I'm saying?
That you kind of serve to everybody's palate.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta kind of.
That's really interesting the way you marketed the ceviche game, kind of like clothing in a way, where you guys are collaborating with different styles. And then curating like a dish and then dropping it.
Yeah.
And then creating that following on the social media.
Oh, I see what you mean, yeah.
Creating like a demand.
Yeah, exactly.
Like people are drawn to it. So they're more entitled, not entitled, they're more enticed to go out of the way to go order, pick it up for you guys, right? Because you guys are doing pickup right now, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then you were mentioning that you're getting into catering events as well, right?
Yeah. Well, we've actually made, usually people when they have a party, they buy like enough for the whole party, you know? So we consider that kind of almost catering.
I'm not gonna lie, dog. It's awkward eating in front of you guys, but
No, bro, go in.
But it's just retarded. I always say one thing. I'm a fat ass, never a foodie. This is fat ass, dog. It's certified fat ass material right here. Oh, yeah. But I could definitely see myself eating this on a fucking mean ass crudolia. Like a sick ass one, you know what I mean?
Sick ass one.
Yeah, food. Like mariscos in my life, yo soy Acapulco. You know? Okay. No, don't worry, bro. It's okay. If you broke this, you broke it. Right. But I'm from Acapulco, dog, and like la gente allá en Acapulco son marisquera. Like they eat fucking anything off the shore. It could be fucking like, what is this? Who knows? Who just put it on the grill, dog? And then like one time food, my mom, like, she was like, oh, porque trajeron a bucket of like something in shells, right? Mm. And they started cracking it open and it looked fucking fishy. Obviously it looked fishy, dog.
Yeah.
It's from the sea. But I was just like, you're gonna eat that? She fucking ate it, food. She had ronchas and shit.
I was just like,
yo, dog, you tripping. My mom like, bring me tequila. And then she was back to normal, you know? But that's the type of people I know. Like mariscos has always been part of my family, you know? Like, I was never that kid that, like, they go to the mariscos and, like, he has his McDonald's meal and shit. You know those kids? Like, hell no.
Chicken tenders?
Yeah, chicken tenders. Like, no tiene chicken nagi.
You were slurping down oysters and shit?
Yeah, I was right there, like, put some in his mamila and shit. And I was like,
crazy, bro.
But, yeah, food, mariscos has a big thing, like, especially now, like during the pandemic, dog, everybody was like picking up mariscos, like going home, zarandeados, fucking everything. But yeah, dog, with Hispanic Heritage Month here now, like it's fucking sick, dog, like to watch our people just like skyrocket to the top doing shit that just like people know how to do, just cook and nails and fucking like yo te corto pelo. That's just
dope. I feel like
the
pandemic created that whole like culture of doing it yourself too, because like people were like, I'm not gonna be waiting around, and that's how it was for us too. We're like, they shut her job down and we're like, listen, we can't just be waiting around, we gotta go. I tell her, we gotta adapt or die. Like you gotta
Keep it moving,
and get with the times, or you're not gonna survive.
And with that Heritage Month thing, I want to highlight that there's a stereotype of Mexicans being lazy, but I want to say that's crazy. We're some of the most hardworking people ever, you know, especially here, like in this area. So this is Linwood, it's Long Beach, and you mentioned you're from South Central. This is a different side of LA that a lot of people don't see. Mm-hmm. It's like where the Mexicans are at. And I mean, there's Mexicans everywhere.
Everywhere. We everywhere, bro. Yeah, yeah.
We're basically like the backbone of LA.
Yeah. Well, there's Mexican foods making sushi, dog. Trip on that one. Food like, hey, they'd be like, arigato. It's like, oh, you're from fucking Oaxaca. What's up with that? And it's like, all right, so I know that restaurant, because I used to work at a restaurant when I first was a young boy. but I know restaurants require a lot of prep work, right? Yeah. And especially mariscos. When mariscos, dog, you better have a sick ass knife work. You know what I mean? You gotta cut cilantro. You gotta cut the cebollas. Bro. You gotta peel the cucumbers. Like, elaborate on that for me a little bit, because a lot of people like nomás like, ain't con cebolla sin cebolla. Like, nah. It's already made, big dog. It's already made. Like, I'm not gonna be there like one by one
You're gonna trip out on this one, because we make every order to order. We don't make batches and just serve. No, we don't do that. Everybody, if you order, your thing is gonna get
customizable.
Yes, exactly.
Recipe's already made. But if you're watching this on a Sunday or whenever, and you're craving a little charol, and you're in the Long Beach area, hit up Charolas Long Playa Larga, bro. That shit is fire, dude. I know that it's kind of awkward not to be like eating and podcasting, so like we're definitely gonna eat after this. But dude, the prep work on how do you get your mariscos? Do you marinate it? Do you pre-marinate some of it? Like,
it just depends on the plate that it is. You know, like if it's hot foods, like he said, we do everything as orders. So we'll prep 2 days before. Prepping as far as peeling the shrimp. Like, that's... Can I cuss?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
What the fuck?
Just asking. It's a bitch. Yeah. Peeling and deveining and cleaning, it's a fucking bitch. Yeah. Like, it's four of us. It's me, him, my dad, and my nephew. We put my nephew on. He's 16. I'm like, you want some money? Right. You got a car? Money. You need gas?
That's right.
Come and peel this shrimp.
He's got a little girlfriend.
Exactly. Well, we're going to the movies tonight, baby.
With the marisco money. So I like to promote, you know, throughout the week, just to kind of get an idea of how much to prepare and how much to prep.
Right.
But we'll usually prep a certain amount and just kind of go from there. Okay, I know I have this amount of ceviche de camarón, so I have to clean this and cut it this way. I have aguachile, I have to peel it, devein it, and then butterfly it. It's a lot of work.
Yeah, so if we know each order, we take out the amount of shrimp. So we already know how much each order is going to take up. We prep that the night before, and just everything in Ziplocs, and put them ready in the fridge roll. The next day. Yeah.
Smart ass.
We
foods.
Just whip them up, boom, and then they get out.
You guys got a whiteboard too, like
everything.
We have a little ticket, little thing. We're trying to get into it. I think we got our operation down. Where if you were to get a food truck, we could do it.
That's what I was gonna say. Like, what's the goal? What are you guys gonna do? Like, you guys want to go restaurant mode? You guys want to go fucking 4x4 and shit, or what?
Bro, well, to be honest, bro, I want a spot where we could got the banda. Gotta have the banda on the mariscos. It could be a vibe, I want it to be a type of vibe, like, because it's not just the food, like it's
a vibe, culture,
it's the whole experience.
I agree with you on that.
One day
that'd be dope.
That's cool.
I saw somebody on my Instagram like cutting like vegetables, like tomatoes and shit, and I hate that shit. And they had put right there, oh, it's like therapy. Like, you crazy, bro. Like, you tripping right now.
What does a day in your kitchen look like? Like, is it hectic? Is it fucking like, bam? I need some detail. I need some, Is the fish like right there just like asoleado and shit? Nah, just kidding.
No, well, everyone has like their role, Like, we'll all prep. Her dad usually makes a ceviche de pescado. He preps the vegetables.
That's what's...
She'll mainly put things together. And if I'm doing Zarandeados, I gotta be outside on the grill.
If it's a Saturday, he's a musician, he'll play. I'm like, all right, fuck it, Saturday.
I gotta wake up early.
Wake up at 7 a.m.
Yeah.
Saturday at 7 a.m.
early.
His face reaction, like stupid early, dog. Still
an AM, bro. Like I'll be feeling all sick when I wake up. Like, oh, it's too early.
I don't want to do this no more, man.
I don't want to do this.
Nah, but you were saying?
Yeah. So he'll get home late. I'll wake up at 7. I try to make everything fresh. Like for the tacos, we make salsa de tomate, so I'll make it the day of. For the tilapias, I make adobo, salsa de adobo. I make that the day of. Yeah. So by the time he wakes up, I'll have trays out, and for him, he does a zarandeado. So I don't touch that. That's up to him. Whatever he does with it, but yeah, it's just prepping.
It's a lot. It's a lot of prep.
Yeah, that's what you're here for. Food, like, yeah. Like you know, just you know, try to tell the people, like, yo, this is our business. We love, you know, I see it as love, you know what I mean?
Oh,
when you
yeah.
create something like this, like a beautiful dish, it's savory. You see the people like, oh, gracias.
The reaction. Yeah, the reaction when they try it. I always get nervous. I get super anxious.
Yeah.
I can't even look at people. I'm like, fuck, man.
Yeah.
Like how you were before we started the podcast, bro. I'm like, he's all like,
awkward.
I was like, he'd be going through the same thing that I feel. And yeah, I was like, oh, and then I see their reaction. Yeah. I'm like, oh. It feels like the best thing, you know, like it just feels good. But it's really all prep work. And then that's why we try to get all pre-orders in so that we know exactly how much to prep. But then we also got to prep for those that like to order last minute. Right. So we got to have a little bit of everything ready.
Yeah, yeah. You want to send a message to them right now?
It's like, hey, put your orders in a couple days before. We got you. We got you. But put them in a little bit.
Make
before.
It difficult, big
make
dog.
It, yeah, make it easy, a little bit easier on us. And
the zarandeado, that's a Nayarit staple, right?
That's a Nayarit staple. The zarandeado originally comes from Nayarit.
Yeah.
It's original. Like, you'll go to other states and they're going to put like this dressing on it and all these condiments. But when you go to Nayarit, I feel like Nayarit, they're connoisseurs. They're like purists,
right?
Wow. They like it from the water to your plate,
right?
And so when they catch the fish, they show you the fish. Okay, boom, all right. Open it up, season it up, and the seasoning is just simple. Mm-hmm. It's three ingredients. And they're local ingredients.
He's like, I don't know what I'm going to tell you.
Like, yo, like, if I tell you, I got to
tell
you.
If I tell you guys, I could tell you guys. But either way, you could copy the sauce, but you can't. It's not going to taste the same.
Yeah, your feet aren't in the sand, dog.
It's salt. It's salt and salsa huichol. That's it.
That's it.
Okay. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's it. It's the most pure. And I've had people try it, and they're like, this shit tastes like, it tastes like fish. I'm like, that's what it's supposed to taste like. And no, and they're like, it's because I've had it other places where they put so much stuff on it that it tastes like the other stuff.
You know what?
You know, I'm like, bro, like, exactly. This is how you're supposed to have it. Like,
kind of how I feel about sour cream. Like, Mexican places, they'll throw on a grip of sour cream or something. I'm like, that's too much sour cream. You know, mucha crema en los tacos.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I was looking at you today, that like, yeah, that's true.
Yeah,
it happens like that a lot. People try to dress shit up, but it's
sometimes,
like,
yeah, no. But like, you want to try like the main component of the dish is the fish. That's what you want to like pop out, you know. Yeah. And when we serve our fish, we do a little ensalada on the side. Yeah. We throw in an ensalada, so we got our tomato. Cucumber and a purple onion, and we throw some because when you go over there to Nayarit, an appetizer is that they give you is an ensalada, and it has cucumber, onion and tomato, but it also has boiled shrimp, big jumbo boiled shrimp like that. So we try to bring that we try to bring you what I know from over there. We try to bring it, we try to replicate it. We also give a little salad with it, so you know the people that know. That go to Nayarit and they know it. Trust, we know it too. Our shit is it's authentic. That's why our shit says authentic Nayarit seafood.
Yeah. Don't ever change, bro.
Charolitas, Playa Larga, and Long Beach. I'm telling you, don't fuck around. Do not miss this fucking zarandeado master here.
Yeah.
Like, you need to wear a fucking black belt that says zarandeado and shit.
I'll be putting my mandil on.
Hell yeah, that's right, fool, with a baseball cap forward, never backward.
Never
forward.
Backward,
But since you guys do mariscos, and like, do you guys ever get tired of it? Like, do you guys ever like be like sometimes you be like, damn, I like this order. Or would you guys ever get tired of mariscos? Nah, huh?
I'm gonna be honest. Yeah. I think just see. It's fire, though. Don't get me wrong. Our food's fire. Yes, but it is. Seeing fire. It every day, cooking it every day, I'll taste it every day, and I'm like, this is bomb. But enough to be like, baby, you want ceviche? Yeah. Like, oh, let's do like something a little different today.
I've reduced it. I still eat aguachiles. Or on the weekend, I'll be like, I want a tostada. And if it's not from Mars, I go buy one somewhere.
What would be your local spot? Like,
we'll bleep it out.
We'll bleep it out, yeah.
No, my local spot, I couldn't even say it because they're my people too from Nayarit. Okay. So, like, there's a little lunch truck that posts up in Compton. And they're from Nayarit too. So okay. it's an older cat that my dad knows. Yeah, but yeah. It's OG, you know, like yeah, it's the OG style. So that's what I like.
Orale, Simon. Very cultural, very rooted. Yeah. I like it, very authentic.
I like places like that. I like going to holes in the wall places, bro. Like I like a lunch truck with a flat tire, like and shit. And it like it doesn't even turn on.
Like the ones on the side of the road on the dirt.
Yeah, they're like they gotta tow it like every day and shit. I like places like that, fool, because they got, like, you know, they got carrot. Like we've been here since fucking 1990 some shit. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah, we saw history. Fucking cops right there. Yeah. Right? Like, what right? Like, nothing. You know what I mean? But I have a spot, too, in South Central. There's a bunch of spots, actually, like that I like to go to. And yeah, shout out to those spots, Jerry. Mm. Yeah. And I'm not going to give them away, either, because you might catch me slipping right there. Yeah. Yeah, dog, man, now you got me all fucking like my like going through my head like so many emotions, like fuck Nayarit, fucking
heritage. Marisco memories.
Marisco memories, fool. Mariscos is fucking fire, dog. I love marisco so much.
For the cruda, huh?
Yeah, dog. I love being crudo and eating mariscos, fool. Even though it hurts.
No, but I love you know it. You can never be mad cuando nace enchilado.
Oh yeah, dog.
You're like you'll be hot. But you can't be mad. You can never get mad.
Yeah. And if you and if you open bottles at the marisco spot with random objects, that's my type of vibe right there. With a fucking spoon, with a dollar bill.
The side of the table.
Yeah, just a...
Yeah. The baby the bottle and shit.
Head, with a camarón. But yeah, dog, I couldn't be happy with you guys like coming. This episode, your guys' episode. I know you guys are gonna cater an event in Long Beach soon, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if you like weed and you like mariscos, they're gonna be soon. You can follow them on Instagram at Charolitas Playa Larga. You'll see it on the screen right now. And they're gonna have cater an event in October at Flight in Long Beach, correct?
Correct.
Yeah. The dates to be announced, but you already know. Follow them. Show some love. Order ahead of time, please. You see the fucking struggle that these people go through. They fucking scratch their head. Like, no. Tiene pepino. But, yeah, dog. We're coming to, like, a segment in our podcast where we talk about... We let our guests talk about their perfect taco. And I want a taco from you, and I want a taco from you. So, let's talk about it. Where you can go wild, bro, any taco you want. What would be your favorite taco?
Well, my favorite taco, bro, I think it would have to be the taco dorado de camarón.
Yeah, yours.
My hours, yeah.
Specifically, like,
bro,
ours.
Ours, bro.
Yeah. There you go, dog.
Yeah, bro. Crunchy shell, seasoned shrimp. You got the curtido. You crack it open. Put the curtido. Put the what do you call that shit?
Whatever, bro.
The green one. The one that the lettuce. Col. You put the lettuce. I forgot, dog.
Col.
Yeah, you put the lettuce. Yeah. And then the consomme that she makes. And then some limon and chile.
Damn, consomme.
And then the little what am I missing? Sour cream and crema and the cheese.
And you guys like fold the taco, put the
we fold them. It goes fried. Mm-hmm. So that, but the thing about it is when you crack it open, it stays solid, bro. Like, you know, so it lets you pack it up and then.
These fools are scientists.
How many of those? In one sitting, dude, on a good day.
You're like, you get home and you're like,
you got the munchies.
I got the munchies, like 10, fool, no lie, like 10.
They're
bomb, fool, like yeah, 10, no lie. Yeah,
I'm gonna have to fucking, I'm gonna have to put my order ahead of time.
You know, I'll give you the pro tip. Put the little salsita verde de habanero with the limon. stupid. My damn fool, stupid. That shit smacks.
Fly Larga is my new spot. Bro. My new spot. Automatic. Stand up. So that 10 fired fucking sick hooked up ass tacos then.
Hooked up.
Damn. I'm looking hungry. That shit does look on fire. And you, ma'am?
I think for me it would be a soft tortilla, a taco de pescado with our spicy chipotle sauce. Something different. I'm a big texture person, so maybe, you know, the pescado a little bit empanizado with the tortilla a little bit softer with some col on top, spicy mayo. Coming soon.
Sick, bro. That fucking taco is like what, like $800 a taco? That one? For me, dog, I don't know. Food for a taco for I want to do a taco now. Bro. You know me, bro. Always a fat ass, never a foodie, dog. Always a fat ass, pinche gordo man. But yeah, for me, dog, I don't know, dude. I want fucking swordfish, swordfish taco. You guys fuck with swordfish?
I've tried it. Yeah, it's a very unique.
Let me taste. Sidetrack on that. Do you guys get any exotic like seafood?
Exotic as
like
in
like. Like callo or like all, yeah,
oh,
right?
Yeah, we get callo, abulón, which is abulón is not you won't find
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you won't find it. It's like
a imitation. Yeah, imitation. Yeah. Yeah, and we have a source and it brings the original one, and there's one tree that we put it in. It's called La Toda Madre. Toda Madre. And it has everything. It has ceviche de pescado, ceviche de camarón. That's the base.
Yeah.
And then it's got pulpo. It's got the.
The
abulón, jaiba, camarón cocido, mm-hmm. aguacate, and then it's not the normal lemon juice that we use. We use a whole different. So we take the juice out. It's already we make it. Then we take the juice out and we add another juice in. Mm-hmm. That's clamato based. So it's clamato with lemon and you know all. You know.
You don't need a safe word to order this, or you don't need a fucking like wink.
Yeah, there's you could call it too, either la mamá. That's what people know, cause it has everything, or a toda madre. So,
yeah. Oh shit! Yeah, fucking up the studio right here. Yeah, that's fucking tight, dude. That's like some secret shit, yeah, off secret menu shit.
No, it's on the menu. Yeah, we just recently started. Exclusive. Nah, but it's just a mix of everything, cause right. I know, like, you say you're a foodie. I'm a marisco foodie. I like to eat everything. Yeah. Like everything, like snail,
yeah,
gallo, yeah. Everything has to do with the fucking ocean.
I like pata de mula is my shit. Okay.
That plate that you just described sounds like a crazy science experiment.
Yeah, like, it was stone
elements. Like, shit,
I've been coming up with some random ass shit, bro. Yeah,
like, look,
the black, the black sauce too. I swear to God, I woke up one day and I was like, you know what would taste good? And I was like, this, and I made it. And we tried it and
fire.
And that's like our most popular thing now. Like that just blows my mind sometimes. Like it just I made it up out of nothing. I just thought this would taste good together. This. And one day, like, because we didn't have nothing to do, we just were like, let's try it.
Ooh. Yeah, concoction. That's and dope, like, man. That's fucking tight, bro. I'm telling you, like, watching you guys explain and like you know, talk about your company and your business and like what you guys put, the effort that you guys put into like making a just one dish, after listening to that, I was like, what the hell? That's crazy, bro. But you could tell that you guys like I said, that you guys like love this and you guys and you know, I'm awkward, you're awkward, you know?
Yeah. It's that social anxiety,
bro. Yeah, dog. It sucks.
Mm-hmm. People make good cooks though.
Yeah, dog. So I be trying some. Where can Winnie get at me, dog?
Well, that's my shit too, bro. That's my shit for the morning.
Yeah. I'm gonna get down today, dog.
Or have you ever had camarón with huevo in the morning?
What the?
You get
shrimp. You get the shrimp. You put the egg and the verdura. Like if you're gonna make a weenie con huevo, and it's bomb with the tortillas and frijoles.
Shit right there. Yeah. That's a Malibu shit right there. That's the fuck,
bro.
Yeah.
We have a lot of things that. That's why I said like. How we curate by drops, we have things more things coming.
Yeah,
we have more things coming. Because there's a lot that we can share with you guys, bro. Like, there's a lot.
We're going to have to wait to see.
Like, yeah. And then, all right, seasons are changing. We got something planned for that, too.
Caldos and shit.
Some caldos.
That's right.
Some tamales. Tamales de camarón. You ever heard of that?
No.
All right. So, right, I bet you a lot of people haven't either. So
it right now.
I'm just exclusive right here. With exclusive with the little brown boys.
Yeah, bro.
Some tamales de camarón.
Damn, this was trying to be the Gordon Ramsay of my mariscos over here and shit, boys.
Yeah, bro. You know, I gotta teach some people. Like Gordon Ramsay.
But that's tight, dog. I wish you guys the best, and like, yeah, you know what I mean. I hope you guys fucking do get to the point where you guys are going to, and then once you get there, be like, you wake up early as fuck, like he does, and just be like, you know what, we got here. Let's keep going.
Yeah,
that's right. So we have to get down to this fucking point where we let our guests' imaginations go wild. We're gonna do Imagine Fool. I hope you guys know. Imagine Fool is where like our guests go crazy with a question, bro. You want to introduce my question?
Yeah. So let's keep going with this cooking thing, this catering thing, these crazy ingredients, these exotic mariscos or anything. Let's say you have the dream catering gig, right? And you have any resource you want. So mariscos, seafood from any place in the world, for any celebrity or athlete or someone you look up to, what would the event be and what would you cater?
Damn.
And for who?
Or it could be like a festival or
something.
Yeah,
whatever. I don't know if there's like a Mexican festival like that. Like a Coachella type, but like a Mexican festival.
I know there's Michelada
maybe
Fest
like,
or
something. Oh, yeah? But like music. Like grupos and bandas and mariachis.
Okay, we'll make one right here at Plaza Mexico.
You know, like if I'm letting my imagination run wild, it would be a music festival, but obviously, you know, Hispanic, Latino music. And maybe make it like, I don't know, buy a ticket and then, you know, you get a table and you can see the artist so and so. And then I think what I would serve personally, it'd be like a surf and turf, maybe like a lobster with the type of meat. Serve like some type of like, I don't know, calla de hacho scallop seared. I don't know, something like that.
Yeah, with like surf champagne food. Only.
Yeah.
Tortillas, like grip of tortillas.
Yeah. handmade tortillas.
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, Selena's there for
some
reason.
Yeah, her ghost is there.
For some fucking reason, she's there.
They fucking holographic her, whatever you call it, hologram her and shit.
I'll buy tickets.
Damn, who would be there? Food fucking, I don't know, dog. Fucking Sábado Gigante, Don Francisco would be there.
Yeah.
El Chacal would be there. Fucking LeBron James, El Bofo. They're just like eating together at the same table. That's funny, bro. But thank you guys for coming, bro. I know that you have a gig to go to, bro.
Yeah.
And thank you guys for coming. And this episode has been brought to you by Charolitas Playa Larga. Go order them. Go order their food from them. They're in Long Beach. I can't say anymore, but thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you for inviting us, bro. You guys got a nice studio. I hope you guys fucking blow up.
Thank you, man. Appreciate you guys. All right, this has been the Little Brown Boys Podcast. We're out.